Permanente. श्रीचैतन्यमनोभिस्तं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वायं रूपकजं मायं ददाति स्वापदं पितं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयतापदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवंश्च श्रीरूपं सत्रजातं सहागना भगिनसन्दितं संसजीवं सर्वैतं सवदूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपदं सहागना भवितं श्रीविशाखामितंश्च हे कृष्णकर्णसिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेशगोपिका कान्ता राधाकान्ता नमस्तुते सप्तकाञ्चन गौरङ्गे राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी वृषमानुसुते देवि प्रणामामि हरिप्रिये वंशकौपातरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमः ॐ विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमाते भक्तिवेदान्ता स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारसतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशधारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री वासवि गौर भक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे. So tomorrow is the auspicious day of the appearance of the pleasure potency of the Supreme Lord, Srimati Radharani.
明天是至尊主的喜乐能量的人格化身，Srimati Radharani的吉祥显现日。
2 weeks back, we celebrated Krishna Janmashtami.
两周之前，我们刚刚庆祝了 Krishna 的 Janmashtami.
So tomorrow is also the Ashtami. It's also the eighth day, and this is the appearance of Srimati Radharani.
明天也是 Ashtami, 也是第八天，这是 Srimati Radharani 的显现日。
So it's a very special day. Radharani, of course, is very merciful, and that is seen by the fact that we only have a half a day fast.
这是一个特殊的日子，而且 Radharani 非常的仁慈，这是为什么我们只是要戒食半天。
So that's something for you all to appreciate.
这是你们所有的人都可以去欣赏的。
And tomorrow we want to make a very nice offering for the pleasure of Srimati Radharani because Radharani herself is a very, very good cook.
明天呢，我们可以为Srimati Radharani做一些很好的供奉，因为Srimati Radharani本人就是一个特别好的厨师。
As a young girl, Srimati Radharani had the opportunity to cook for Durvasa Muni, who was a powerful sage, and he had come to visit their home. So Durvasa Muni was so pleased with Srimati Radharani's behavior and her cooking, that he blessed her that whenever she would cook, whatever she would cook, it would be just like nectar.
Durvasa Muni 对于 Radharani 的行为举止以及烹调非常的满意，于是他祝福他，无论他做什么都像甘露一样。
So, Srimati Radharani had the blessings of Devasa Muni, and this was known to Mother Yashoda. So Mother Yashoda would request Srimati Radharani to cook for Lord Krishna.
Radharani 得到了 Devasa Muni 祝福的这件事情传到了 Yashoda 妈妈的耳朵里，于是 Yashoda 妈妈就邀请 Radharani 为 Krishna 做饭。
Lord Krishna would, as Lord Krishna grew up, he would be given charge of the cows, and he would go off to the forest, and he would be in the forest all day. They would just take some yogurt and rice with them to eat in the forest, and they would come home at night and eat supper.
主 Krishna 他被赋予了照顾牛的这个职责，于是他整天在森林里面放牛。只有到晚上的时候才会回家，白天呢他就在森林里面吃一些酸奶还有米饭，晚上回家吃晚餐。
And so the whole day Srimati Radharani would be in the kitchen preparing foodstuffs for the pleasure of Lord Krishna.
所以整个的白天 Radharani 都会在厨房里忙着做好吃的东西，为了取悦 Krishna.
And she would cookShe would be over the hot fires all day cooking, preparing different preparations for the satisfaction of Lord Shri Krishna.
她整天都会待在火热的炉子旁边，然后做着各种各样的菜肴，就是为了取悦 Shri Krishna.
So, the name Radha is not found in Srimad Bhagavatam, because it is said that Sukadeva Goswami, he felt that if he would utter her name, it would bring him so much ecstasy, he may not be able to continue speaking Srimad Bhagavatam.
Radha 这个词在整个的 Srimad Bhagavatam 之中都找不到，据说是因为 Sukadeva Goswami 如果发出了他的名字，那么他就会因为过于狂喜而没有办法继续讲述 Srimad Bhagavatam。
So we don't find any mention of her name there, but he would simply say, when he would talk about, he would simply say, one of the gopis, one gopi.
在整个的诗曼八个堂之中 找不到 Radharani 的名字，每当舒克对格斯瓦米提到 Radharani 的时候，他就会说有一位 Gopi。
But the Acharyas have identified that this Gopi is actually Srimati Radharani.
但是 Acharya 们他们认出来他所指的这个 Gopi 就是 Srimati Radharani。
And they have also told us that theAlthough he didn't mention, although Sukadeva Goswami didn't mention directly the name of Radha, he did mention, indicate the position of Srimati Radharani.
尽管 Sukadeva Goswami 并没有直接提到 Radharani 的名字，但是他却表明了 Radharani 的地位。
The word Radha, no,indicates that one who is the most expert in the worship of Lord Krishna.
Radha 这个词的意思就是一个人最专业、最擅长崇拜主是 Krishna.
So this is a fitting description for Srimati Radharani, who is the queen of Vrindavan.
这是一个对于 Srimati Radharani 非常适合的描述，她是 Vrindavan 的王后。
Of course, she appeared in Varsana, in the home of Maharaj Vrishabhanu and Mother Kirtika.
当然了，她显现在 Varsana， 她的父亲是 Vrishabhanu 王，她的母亲是 Kirtika.
And it is said that when Srimati Radharani appeared, her eyes were closed.
据说当须玛提·瓦德拉米显现的时候，他的双眼是闭上的。
And she didn't open her eyes for several days.
她好几天都没有睁开眼睛。
So mother and father were a little worried that why this girl doesn't open her eyes.
她的父亲和母亲很担心，为什么这个姑娘，她这个小女孩不睁眼呢？
But then it happened, after some days, Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda came there, and they brought their child, baby Krishna.
结果过了一段时间 ，Nanda Maharaj 还有 Yashoda 妈妈把他们自己的小儿子带来了，也就是婴儿 Krishna.
And as soon as baby Krishna came in front of Srimati Radharani, immediately she opened her eyes and she saw Lord Krishna.
当婴儿 Krishna 来到 Srimati Radharani 面前的时候。他立刻睁开了眼睛，看到了
是
Krishna。
So Srimati Radharani is the most chaste of all ladies.
所以 Srimati Radharani 是所有女人之中最贞洁的。
Chastity is the most important qualification for a woman.
对一个女人来讲，最重要的品质便是贞洁。
And Srimati Radharani shows that in the highest.Level of chastity.
而 Srimati Radharani 她所展示的是最高级别的贞洁。
It is said one time in Vrindavan, the sister-in-law of Radharani.She declared, we want to have a competition to find out who is the most chaste lady in Vrindavan.
有一次在 Vrindavan, Radharani 的小公主提出来要开展一场竞赛，看看在 Vrindavan 最贞洁的女人是谁。
And the competition was that they had to carry a pot which was full of holes in the bottle.And they would fill the pot with water. And it was said that if the woman is very chaste, then not one drop of water will come out from the pot.
This competition is to take a pot, but the pot's bottom has a lot of holes. To fill the pot with water, it is said that the woman who is very chaste, then not one drop of water will come out from the pot.
Just like you see when we bathe the deities after the.They'll come with the water and they'll pour the water through a pot full of holes in the bottom.
就像你们看神像沐浴 Abhishek 的时候，在沐浴的结尾会拿一个像筛子一样的罐子，然后往里边浇水。
And the water will wash the deity.
而这个水呢，就会冲洗神像的身体。
So it was arranged that all the women in Vrindavan were to test their chastity.The most chaste woman should be able to carry the water in her head without even the hair getting wet.
于是大家就安排文大们所有的女人都要参与这个比赛，而最贞洁的女人会把这一罐子顶在自己的头上，而自己的头发不会湿。
So different gopis, they all thought, I'm chaste, I can do it. But as soon as they put the pot, It got so wet.
不同的公主们都在想，我能做到，我是最贞洁的。但一旦把这一罐子顶在头上之后，哗，水全流出来了，全身都湿了。
And different gopis were all trying. The in-laws of Radharani, they tried, they couldn't do it.
不同的公主们都在尝试，而且 Radharani 的这个小姑子也尝试了，但是都做不到。
So then somebody said, why doesn't Radharani try?
有人说为什么 Radharani 不试一试呢？
And of course her sister-in-law is very nasty sometimes. She said, Radharani, no, she's not chaste. How could she ever do it?
当有人提出来让 Radharani 尝试一下的时候， Radharani 的小姑子就嗤之以鼻，不屑一顾，就说 Radharani 她怎么能做得到？
But when Srimati Radharani took the pot, she could carry the pot, not one drop of water came out.
但是当圣玛吉拉德拉尼把罐子顶起来的时候，他就一滴水都没有漏出来。
So you can see, maybe some of you ladies like to try.
你可以看看，也许你们之中的有一些女士们也可以试一试。
Yeah, would be difficult.
会非常困难。
But Srimati Radharani tried to understand she is a transcendental personality.
但我们要理解的是，释迦牟尼佛 Radharani 他是一位超然的人物。
Srila Prabhupada was very cautious about speaking much about Srimati Radharani.
释迦牟尼佛在谈到释迦牟尼佛 Radharani 的时候非常的小心。
And he also didn't like devotees to chant, you know, Radhe Radhe all the time.
而且他不喜欢附近的人一直都在唱诵 Radhe Radhe.
On special days like tomorrow, you could do it.
在特殊的日子，比如说明天可以做。
But we don't make a general habit.
但是我们不会把它变成一个日常的习俗。
If people, sometimes in Vrindavan, people would say to Srila Prabhupada,They would say Radhe Radhe, he would simply reply Hare Krishna.
在文达本，很多的人跟释迦牟尼佛打招呼，说 Radhe Radhe， 但是呢，释迦牟尼佛只会用 Hare Krishna 来回答。
Because it's a very confidential subject matter to hear about the pastimes of Radha and Krishna.
因为聆听 Radha and Krishna 的逍遥时光，这是非常机密的主题。
And in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj goes to some length to describe the difference between lust and love.
在 Chaitanya Charitamrita 之中 ，Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami 他就描述了在爱和色欲之间的区别。
That lust is in the material world, but love.Is in the spiritual world.
色欲在物质世界，爱在灵性世界。
What people think of as love in the material world is not really love, but it's a preventive form of love. It is actually lust.
人们认为在这个物质世界里的爱其实并不是爱，是一种爱的扭曲，其实是色欲。
And so the lust of Kupja for Krishna is also not on the level of the love of the gopis.
Kupja 对 Krishna 的那种喜欢并不处在 gopi 们的层面上。
Kupja was a hunchback lady and she was making sandalwood paste for Kamsa.
Kupja 是一位驼背的女子，她专门为 Kamsa 准备檀香浆。
And when she met Lord Krishna,She was very attracted to Lord Krishna, and she offered all the sandalwood paste for the pleasure of Lord Krishna.
当她看到 Krishna 的时候，非常受到 Krishna 的吸引，于是她把所有的檀香浆都供奉给了 Krishna.
And Lord Krishna appreciated her. The lady, she was a young woman, but she had a hunchback. So Lord Krishna stood on her toes, and then.Gave her a jerk and straightened her.
Kupja, she is a very young girl, but she is a hunchback. So Krishna stepped on her toes and then lifted her foot, then pushed her up, and straightened her.
And Lord Krishna, by his transcendental touch, he transformed her into an attractive young woman.
So Krishna, through his transcendental power, made Kupja into a very attractive.
And she desired to enjoy the company of Lord Krishna.
而她呢，想去享受跟 Krishna 的陪伴。
But her attraction was like was not real love, but it was more like lust.
但是她对 Krishna 的这种喜爱之情，并不是真正的爱，更像是色欲。
But the love of the gopis that is very pure. Transcendental.
可是 gopi 们的这种爱是非常纯粹而且非常超然的。
So the love of Kuja was like iron, but the love of the gopis was like gold.
Kuja 的爱就好像铁一样，而 gopi 们的爱就像金子一样。
So the gopis, they have the highest feelings for Lord Krishna.
Gopi 们对 Krishna 有最高级的情感。
So there are different relationships for the devotees and their affection for Lord Krishna. And according to their relationship, Lord Krishna will reciprocate with them accordingly.
不同的奉献者按照他们跟 Krishna 的不同的情感，他们不同的关系，按照这种不同的关系，主 Krishna 也会相应的跟他们有不同的交流回应。
The first level of relationship with Krishna is the stage of Santa Dasa, or the stage of neutrality.
跟 Krishna 的第一个级别的这种关系呢，叫 Santa Rasa， 也就是中性的关系。
Sometimes Srila Prabhupada will call it the stage of adoration for Krishna.
有的时候，释迦牟尼帕德就管这个叫做对 Krishna 的欣赏和仰慕。
In other words, they appreciate the beauty of Lord Krishna.
换句话说，他们非常的欣赏 Krishna 的美丽。
But they don't do any service.
但是他们并不做任何服务。
We get people like that, you know, come to Krishna consciousness in the beginning.
我们有这样的人，有一些人一开始来到 Krishna 知觉之中。
They're interested, they're seeing Krishna, and they're thinking, you know, he's very beautiful, everything about him is very attractive.
他们感兴趣是因为他们觉得 Krishna 非常的俊美，而且呢，这一切非常的吸引他们。
But they don't take up any active service.
但他们却不会接受任何积极的服务。
And we see this kind of rasa among people like the four Kumaras.
我们可以在四库玛尔兄弟之中看到这种类型的 rasa.
Four Kumaras are in Santara.
库玛尔四兄弟就处在 Santara 之中。
They reside usually in Tapaloka, which is the planet just below Brahmaloka, at the top of the universe.
他们住在 Tapaloka， 也就是仅次于 Brahmaloka， 仅次于宇宙之中最高级星球的地方。
And there they're absorbed, meditating on the Supreme Lord.
他们在那里全神贯注地冥想至尊主。
But they don't do any seva.
但他们不做任何的 seva， 不
做任何服务。They don't do anything physically for the pleasure of the Lord.
他们不会为了取悦主而亲身地去做任何的事情。
And then above Santa Rasa is Dasarasa, the one for being the servant to Lord Krishna.
在 Santa Rasa 之上呢是仆人的这种 Dasarasa.
We all want to consider that relationship that we are the servant of Krishna.
我们都被认为处在这种关系之中，我们都是 Krishna 的仆人。
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Jivar Swarupahaya Nitya Krishna Das. We are all eternally servants of Krishna.
主 Chaitanya 说我们全都是 Krishna 的永恒的仆人。
So in Vrindavan, Krishna has his servants. People like Raktak and Patrak, they're Krishna's servants in his home.
在 Vrindavan, Krishna 有仆人，比如说 Raktak,他们都是 Krishna 家里的仆人。
Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda, they were Vaishya, they were wealthy people. They had 900,000 cows. So they had also servants there. And two of the servants, Rakta and Patra, they were active in serving Krishna.
Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda Mama, 他们是 Vaishya, 他们是非常富有的人。他们有900,000头乳牛，然后他们也有很多的仆人。于是，在所有的这些仆人之中呢，有 Rakta， 还有 Patra， 他们专门服务 Krishna。
And then in Dwarka, Krishna has a different servant. He has Daruka to drive his chariot. Dwarka is also servant of Krishna.
在 Dwarka, Krishna 有一个不同的仆人，他的名字叫Daksha。
Dwarka。
Dwarka。然后他是专门为 Krishna 驾驶马车的。
So Dashyada, we want to have that mood, the servant of Krishna.
这就是 Dasyaras， 我们想处在这种成 Krishna 的仆人的关系之中。
When we get initiation, you get a name, and with the name comes also Das or Dasi.
当我们启迪的时候，我们会给你们一个名字，连同这个名字一起的，还有 Das 或者是 Dasi.
Right, we're all servants.
我们全都是仆人。
We're in the service industry.
我们是在仆人的工业之中。
We're not manufacturing, we're just simply doing service.
我们并不制造任何的东西，我们只是在做服务。
So, above Dasyaras is Sakyaras.
在
Friendship.
在 Dasyaras 之上呢是 Sakyaras， 也就是友谊。
And Arjuna, of course, is a friend of Krishna.
当然了，阿朱呢是 Krishna 的朋友。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, "Bhaktosime sakacheti rahasyam hi etendutamam." Lord Krishna is telling Arjuna, "Because you are my devotee as well as my friend, therefore I am speaking this knowledge to you."
在 Bhagavad Gita 之中，主 Krishna 告诉阿朱呢说，因为你既是我的朋友，又是我的奉献者。所以我才把这门知识告诉你。
And in Dwarka, Lord Krishna has friends like Uddhava. Uddhava is like Krishna's secretary, but at the same time, he always thinks of himself as being below the position of. He never thinks he's equal to Krishna, and even if they're given seats.He will not sit on the same seat on the same level as Krishna. He will always sit below Krishna.
在 Dwarka, Krishna 还有一个朋友，他的名字叫 Uddhava。然后 Uddhava 呢，就好比是 Krishna 的秘书。尽管他地位如此崇高，但是呢，他一直认为他是在 Krishna 之下。即使是他们一起坐的话，他不会坐在跟 Krishna 一个平面上，他总会坐在比 Krishna 的座位更低一层的地方。
Srila Prabhupada described when he was a very new devotee one time, his Guru Maharaj was there and he came and he sat beside him on the same level as his Guru Maharaj.
Srila Prabhupada, 当他年轻的时候，他见到他的 Guru Maharaj， 他就坐在跟他的 Guru Maharaj 同一层的这个平面上。
And his spiritual master didn't say anything to him.
他的灵性导师没有对他说任何的话。
He didn't think, "What's it here? What's it down there?" Because he knew, you know, he's a new man. He thought, given time, you know, he will learn in the future. What is the etiquette?
他的灵性导师并没有说，哎，你下去，坐到底下去，而是他知道他是一个年轻人，是一个新人，给他足够的时间，然后他就会学习到礼仪的这些方面。
Srila Prabhupada always remembered that he didn't know fully the etiquette and he just, in a friendly mood, he sat beside his spiritual master.
Srila Prabhupada 是一直记得，当时他还不懂这些礼仪，所以他就像个朋友一样坐在他的灵性导师的身边。
So, Lord Krishna has friends like Uddhava who.Always thinking himself subordinate. He associates with Krishna, and Krishna will sometimes ask Uddhava, "What do you think? What should we do?"
虽然 Uddhava 是 Krishna 的朋友，但是他总认为自己是 Krishna 的下属，而且 Krishna 呢，他总会问他，你觉得怎么样？我们应该怎么办？
Sometimes Prabhupada would call disciples to his room, and he would ask them.What do you think? What should we do about this problem?
有的时候，释迦牟尼佛会把他的门徒叫进房间里，然后问他，你觉得现在的情况怎么样？我们应该对这个问题怎么办？
Prabhupada like to hear from people.
Prabhupada 想从其他人那里听取意见。
So Uddhava was a friend of Lord Krishna, but not equal to him.
Uddhava 是 Krishna 的朋友，但并不是跟他平起平坐的。
In Vrindavan, Krishna has friends who are equal to him, and they wrestle with him, and they will fight with him, and they will steal it. Sometimes they'll take his food from him, and they'll have many different games with each other.
在文达文克什呢有一些朋友他们是跟克什呢平等的他们会跟克什呢一起摔跤跟克什呢一起做游戏跟甚至是偷走克什呢的吃的东西
Red cowherd boys like Stoka Krishna and Sudama, Shudam and Subal and Rishabha and these different people there are many cowherd boys they're very intimate friends of Krishna
用牧牛童，比如说 Stoka Krishna、Sudama、Subal， 还有就是其他的这些人是 Krishna 非常亲密的朋友。
And the Srimad Bhagavatam describes that these boys have all performed many pious activities over many lifetimes to be able to be friends with Krishna.
在 Srimad Bhagavatam 之中描述到这些。Krishna 的牧牛童朋友，他们都是生生世世做了很多的虔诚活动，然后才能够得到机会成为 Krishna 的朋友，跟他一起玩耍。
And then about Sakyarasa, then we have Vatsalyarasa, parenthood. And Krishna's parents in Dwarka are Vasudev and Devaki.
在这种朋友。Sakyarasa 之上呢是 Vatsalyarasa 也就是父母之爱 Krishna 在 Dwarka 他的父母是 Vasudeva 和 Devaki
Oh, of course, also in Mathura Krishna appeared in Mathura so Vasudeva and Devaki were there Later on, they moved to Dwarka
当然了还有在 Mathura 在 Mathura Krishna 的父母也是 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 他出生在那里后来他们搬到了 Dwarka
So in Vaikuntha Krishna's parents areVasudev and Devaki.
在白昆塔 ，Krishna 的父母是 Vasudeva 和 Devaki.
But in Goloka Vrindavan, Krishna's parents are Nanda and Yashoda.
但是在 Goloka Vrindavan, Krishna 的父母是 Nanda 和 Yashoda.
And some elderly gopis, they're also like Krishna's mother.
还有一些年长的 gopi 们，他们也像 Krishna 的母亲一样。
Krishna will respect the elders just like mother and father.
Krishna 尊敬长辈，把他们当作自己的父亲和母亲。
And above mother and above Vatsalyarasa, we have Madhurya Rasa.
在 Vatsalya Rasa 之上，我们有 Madhurya Rasa,
which means the mellow of conjugal love, and this is seen, of course, by Well, first of all, we have Krishna's wives.
这个指的是情侣之爱的风味。首先呢，我们知道有 Krishna 很多妻子。
Right. In Dwarka, Krishna has his 16,108 queens, and they're all in the mood of conjugal love with Lord Krishna.
在 Dwarka, Krishna 有16,108位王后，她们全都处在这种，
There are two divisions of conjugal love. One is with marriage and one is without marriage.
在情侣之爱之中有两个范畴，一种是结了婚的，一种是没有结婚的。
Parakya means with marriage, and parakya is without marriage. So in Dwarka, it's swakya madhurya rasa.
Swakya 指的是结了婚的 Parakya 指的是没有结婚的在 Dwarka 呢大家的这种关系是 Swakya Madhurya Rasa
And in Vrindavan you have Parakya Rasa The gopis they enjoy this Parakya Rasa with Lord Krishna
在 Vrindavan 他们的关系是 Parakya Rasa 那些 gopi 们跟 Krishna 享受的是这种 Parakya Rasa
But we should never equateThe dealings between Lord Krishna and the gopis with the mundane affairs of people in the material world.
但是我们永远不应该把 Krishna 跟牧牛姑娘 Gopi 们之间的交往等同于物质世界的世俗之人。
Material world, you see, young people sometimes they live together without marriage, so that is abominable. That is disgusting.
在物质世界里，有时候我们可以看到年轻人没有结婚就同居在一起，这个是非常令人恶心的事情。
But that the dealing of parakya ras between Krishna and the gopis in the spiritual world.That is the highest loving relationship.
但是在 Krishna 和 Gopi 们之间的这种爱的关系是灵性世界之中最高级的爱的关系。
Because there is the greatest loving affection between Krishna and the Gopis.
因为这个是 Krishna 和 Gopi 之间的最高级别的爱和关爱的这种情感。
So this parakya rasa is seen there in Vrindavan.
因此呢 Parakya Rasa 这种关系可以在 Vrindavan 看到
You don't see it in other places
在其他的地方你是看不到的
So Lord Krishna enjoys the loving mood of his devotees
主 Krishna 非常的喜欢跟他的奉献者一起享受这种情感
And he reciprocates with them according to their mood
而且他按照他们的情感跟大家交流回应。
But he has a special appreciation for those who have spontaneous natural attraction to him.
但是他对于那些有自发的、自然的受到他吸引的人有特殊的情感。
If people worship Krishna simply according to the rules and regulations,That's nice, but it's not so attractive to Krishna.
如果人们只是按照规范原则崇拜 Krishna 的话，这也是好的，但是并不是特别的吸引 Krishna.
Just following the different rules and regulations is what we call Vaidhi Bhakti.
仅仅是遵守各种不同的规则和规范，我们管这个叫 Vaidhi Bhakti.
But above Vaidhi Bhakti is.Raga Bhakti,
但是在 Vaidhi Bhakti 之上是 Raga Bhakti,
which is the mood of spontaneous devotion to Krishna.
这就是对 Krishna 的自发的奉爱之情。
Where the devotee thinks of Krishna in one of these different rasas.
在其中呢，一个奉献者他就会跟 Krishna 认为处在其中的一种 rasa 里。
And they will even think sometimes that Krishna is subordinate to them.
有的时候他们甚至会认为 Krishna 是从属于他们的。
Just like Mother Yashoda can bind up Krishna.
就像亚瑟的妈妈，她可以把 Krishna 绑起来。
And Srimati Radharani can get angry towards Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 可以生 Krishna 的气。
Nanda Maharaja can complain about Krishna.
Nanda Maharaja 可以抱怨 Krishna.
Or we see in the case of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how his father was always chastising his son, Nimai Pandit Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He would tell him, behave properly. You're the son of a Brahmana. You should behave like a Brahmana.
在出现他的马哈帕布的例子之中，我们可以看到加格纳的米舍经常去责怪他的儿子，也就是尼麦潘迪，或者说出现他的马哈帕布经常告诉他说：“哎，你要行为举止非常的恰当，你是一个 Brahmana 的儿子，所以你的行为举止要像 Brahmana 一样。”
Lord Chaitanya would enjoy playing different tricks on people. Sometimes people would be meditating, and he would splash water on them.
出柴丹内非常喜欢跟别人开玩笑，有时候人家正在冥想，但出柴丹内就朝着人家泼水。
And sometimes people would be standing in the Ganga up to the waist, chanting the Gayatri Mantra. And Lord Chaitanya would come swimming under the water and would grab their foot.
有的时候有其他的人站在齐腰深的恒河水之中，在唱诵 Gayatri Mantra。 但主产他们就会潜泳到下边去抓住他们的脚。
And do different tricks like this, people would get upset, would complain about them.
然后主产他们老是跟人家开这样的玩笑，于是呢，人们就很不高兴，去抱怨他。
So his father Jagannath Mishra would then chastise his son because he would get complaints from people. And Jagannath Mishra would tell his son, you know, you should behave properly. Don't make people angry. Don't have them complain about you.
Jagannath Mishra 就会责怪住 Jagannath， 因为他受到了很多其他人的抱怨，就会告诉他你。
Would go to sleep after he had chastised Nimai Pandit. When he would go to sleep in the night, he would have a dream. And in his dream, a Brahmana would come to him and say, you know, you should be careful how you speak to your son. He is not an ordinary person.
当迦叶那密舍责怪完主产丹念之后去睡觉的时候，他做一个梦。在梦里，有个 Brahmana 来到他的面前，跟他说：“你知道吗？你不应该用那种抱怨的语气跟你儿子说话。你不知道他是谁，他并不是一个普通的人。”
But Jagannath Mishra would look and he would talk to the Brahmana and say, "Well, he's my son. I'm his father. It's my duty to chastise him."
Jagannath Mishra 就看着那个 Brahmana 说：“我是他的父亲，他是我的儿子，我去责怪他，这是我的职责。”
So this is the mood of raga bhakti, that due to the loving affection between the Lord and his devotees, sometimes the devotee will take the superior position to the Lord.
这就是 raga bhakti 的情感，在主和奉献者的交往之中呢，有的时候奉献者他会接受一种认为比主还要更高的地位。
So Lord Krishna enjoys being under the control of his loving devotees.
主 Krishna 非常的喜欢受到他的充满爱心的奉献者的控制。
Although Krishna himself is the supreme Lord, the supreme controller, he takes pleasure in putting himself under the devotees who love him so much.
尽管主 Krishna 他是至尊的享受者，至尊的控制者。但他仍然有的时候非常喜欢让自己置于他的挚爱的奉献者的控制之下。
We have to understand that when Lord Krishna appeared, it was a very special time in the day of Brahma.
我们必须要明白，主产丹的显现的时候是在主 Brahma 这一天中非常特殊的时刻。
The Supreme Personality of Godhead appears only once.In the day of Brahma.
至尊人格首神他只是作为主产丹念只在主 Brahma 这一天之中显现一次。
But the Lord incarnates in different forms, usually different Vishnu avatars will incarnate in every yuga.
通常呢主他会有不同的化身，在每一个 yuga 每一个年代都有他的化身。
And there's 1,000 ages in one day of Brahma.So there are countless, there are many, many incarnations of the Lord. And when the Lord comes, his business is killing the demons. But killing the demons, that is not the business of the personality of Godhead. That is the business of the Lord's incarnation.But the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He comes to give pleasure to His devotees. And He comes to take, especially He wants to teach the importance of this Raga Bhakti, the mood of spontaneous devotion.So this was appreciated that when Lord Krishna appeared, the time for the appearance of the incarnation which was to establish the Yuga Dharma. And to kill the demons, remove the burden on the earth. Then it coincided with the appearance of the personality of Godhead. So when Lord Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago, he was not just simply an incarnation. But he was the source of all incarnations. And all the different forms, all the different forms of the Lord's incarnations, they're all included within that one Supreme Personality of Godhead. So within that form of Lord Krishna, there is also the form of Lord Vishnu and all of the different avatars of Vishnu. They're all included within that one Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is Lord Sri Krishna. As it's described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Ite Chamsa Kalapumsa, Krishna's two Bhagavans, Vaivam. That Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Swayam Bhagavan. So Lord Krishna appears, and his purpose is to, remove the burden. He's going to remove the burden of the earth. The earth was overburdened with so many demons. So he will arrange for the killing of the different demons, and that will be done the form of Vishnu. But Lord Krishna also wants to give pleasure to his very special devotees. And the best of all of these devotees are the gopis. They were not married to Krishna. But they love Krishna more than anyone. That they would sacrifice everything for Krishna. And even their chastity was sacrificed for the pleasure of Krishna. And the best of all the gopis, of course we think there's one special gopi who has the greatest love for
Krishna.
Of course that is personified in the form of Srimati Radharani, who is the Madini Shakti of Lord Krishna. There are three different spiritual potencies, main potencies of Lord Krishna in the spiritual world. There is the Ladini Shakti, the pleasure potency. Then there is the Sandini Shakti, which is the maintenance potency. And then there's the Samvit potency, which is the cognitive potency. So Lord Krishna likes to enjoy, and he gets his enjoyment through this Ladini Shakti. However, when Lord Krishna came, he was naturally enjoying with the gopis, but he could understand that they're getting more pleasure than he was getting.
然而当主 Krishna 在跟 gopi 们享受的时候，他感觉到那些 gopi 们他们的享受超过自己的享受。
And he thought, I'm supposed to be the supreme enjoyer.
他就想，我应该是至高无上的享受者。
But they're enjoying more than me.
可是他们比我享受的还多。
They're enjoying millions of times more than me.
他们的享受比我大好几百万倍。
So he thought, how can I ever get the pleasure which they're getting?
他就在想，我怎么才能够得到他们所得到的那种快乐呢？
And this is why Lord Krishna came in the Kali Yuga as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
这就是为什么主 Krishna 在 Kali Yuga 作为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到来。
And he came to experience this love for Krishna.
他来体验这种对 Krishna 的爱。
When he spoke Bhagavad Gita, he told everyone to surrender.
当他讲述巴格毕达的时候，他告诉每个人都要臣服于他。
But now in the Kali Yuga, he has come as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he is teaching everyone how to surrender.
但现在在卡利瑜伽，他作为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 到来，他在教导每一个人如何的去臣服。
Before he was just telling them to surrender, but now.As Mahaprabhu has come to show them how to surrender.
之前他只是告诉大家要臣服，但是当他作为马哈普布到来的时候，他在实际的展示应该如何去臣服。
And sometimes we think rituals are very important, and so many different rules and regulations are important. But actually, what is really important?It's that mode of natural love and affection for the Lord.
有的时候我们会认为仪式是非常重要的，有时候我们认为这种规则规范是最重要的，但其实是那种很自然的自发的爱的情感对 Krishna 才是最重要的。
Srila Prabhupada referred to two authorities in this matter. He quoted first of all.Maharaj Kula Shekhar.
Srila Prabhupada 在这方面引用两位权威的观点。第一，其中的一位是 Maharaj Kula Shekhar.
Maharaj Kula Shekhar was in this world long before Lord Krishna appeared. So he was a great devotee of Lord Rama.
Maharaj Kula Shekhar 是在 Krishna 显现之前很久显现的。他是。
Yeah, he's a great devotee.
他是主 Rama 的一位伟大奉献者。
But at the same time, he also glorified Lord Krishna.
但同时，他也在荣耀主 Krishna.
He was the one he's famous as saying, "Let me die now while I can still chant the holy name. If I have to wait till death comes, my mouth will be choked up, and I may have difficulty to chant the holy name. So it's better I should die now."
他最著名的格言就是说，最好让我现在就死，因为我现在还可以唱诵主的圣名。如果等到我就是病得不行再死的话，那我的嗓子都会变得哽咽，被痰给堵塞，我就没办法唱诵圣名。所以最好还是让我现在就死吧。
You can get the book, the Mukunda Mala Stotra. This is the teachings of Maharaj Kula Shekhar.
你们可以去看看，有一本书名字叫做 Mukunda Mala Stotra， 这就是 Kula Shekhar 国王写的书。
Srila Prabhupada began translating some of the verses and then later on it was completed by one of Prabhupada's disciples.
Srila Prabhupada 曾经开始他翻译了这本书的一些诗节，但最后呢是由他的一个门徒完成的。
But Kula Shekhar is tellingNo need to do rituals. Don't worry about doing a lot of rituals and rules and regulations. Just simply take shelter of the lotus feet of the Lord. And in this way, your life will be successful.
Kula Shekhar 说不要去担心那些仪式， 不要去管那些规范和规则，只要臣服于主的莲花足，你的生命就会达到成功。
And then he also quotes Raghunath Das Goswami, who wrote the book called Mana Shiksha.
然后他还引用了 Raghunath Das Goswami, 他这个后者写了一本书叫做 Mana Shiksha.
And Raghunath is saying the same thing with Maharaj Kulashekar. He said, no need to do all these rituals. If you have devotion to the Lord, if you're fully attached to the Lord, that is the success.
Raghunath Das Goswami 他说的跟 Kulashekar 国王是一模一样的，你不要去担心那些规范规则仪式，你只要脱离 Krishna 的莲花足，你的生命就会成功。
But to come to that level, you have to go through all the rules and regulations. You have to first of all practice rules and regulations, and then come to that stage.
但为了达到这个层面，你必须首先要修习所有的规范和规则，然后之后呢，你才能达到这个层面。
So it's not an easy thing to come to that level.
所以达到这个层面并不是一件容易的事情。
We have to be very careful not to try to jump to such a high level. You have to move gradually, step by step.
我们必须要非常的小心，不要一蹴而就，一下子就超越这种层面。我们要一步一步的逐渐去做。
Okay, it's getting late. We have to stop now.
好了，现在已经晚了，我们就此停止吧。
You have to go home. You have to come back for Mangal Arti.
你们现在回家，然后呢，要回来参加 Mangal Arti.
Tomorrow is an important day. You don't want to be late for Mangal Arti.
明天是非常重要的日子，你们不想晚，就是 Mangal Arti 迟到吧。
So we'll see you tomorrow.
那我们明天见。Hare Krishna.